Hi everyone, you probably found this video because you're searching for tennis elbow test. So tennis elbow is a problem with the tendon where it attaches to the common extensor origin on the epicondyle. And so to test for it, there's a lot of things that we need to differentiate between, because we know that elbow pain can be referred from the neck. You can have it referred from a nerve if it's coming down. It can be, if you've got elevation of the first rib, that can irritate the nerve down into the lateral elbow. And so what we really need to be thinking of is looking at what is the mechanism. So a lot of diagnoses, 85% of diagnoses are made within the talking part of the assessment. That's why actually getting an online consultation at the moment, it's locked down. So getting an online consultation can work, or a face-to-face I always prefer, just because it's much, much easier. I'm a chartered physio and I find it just easier to get hands-on and really look at combining brain and working out what's causing it to actually getting treatment as well. And so we need to look at the differential diagnosis. So if the mechanism is that you've had some overload of the wrist extensors, so that could be things like using tools, using horse whip. I see a lot of horse riders, so sometimes when people are lunging, that's a common mechanism. It's not actually, lots of people get confused because it's called tennis elbow. It's not always just caused by tennis. Lots of the time it's caused if you're, you know, typing, or you've been having, a lot of people working at home may have been in a different position. So really think about the mechanism. Has there been a history of trauma? Has there been any really strong trauma that may have caused irritation or damage to the ligaments around that area? You've got lots of structures that can be affected. You've got collateral ligaments which go either side of the elbow. You've got the insertion of the tricep. You've got the insertion of the bicep. You've got golfer's elbow, which is on the inside normally. You've got the nerves that are coming down through that area, and you've got Tinel's problem as well that you can get sort of from the nerve. So we're looking at whether there's any pins and needles that are associated with it. Pins and needles might sort of indicate that there's a nerve involvement in it. We're looking at the range of movement. Is there any stiffness in it? Sometimes with tennis elbow you can get stiffness, but not normally. We're looking at supination and pronation, looking at your rotation, and actually having a little feel into those joints and the bones around that area as well to make sure that they're moving as they should do. There is some really good evidence for, if you're doing some work with for tennis elbow, where you are you're doing a joint mobilization combined with a squeeze and then an extension, and that can be really, really helpful. I've had some really tricky tennis elbows that weren't improving with other physios, and we've tried that and that's worked really, really well. So thinking about the actual test that we would do, we would look at your extensors. So we would look grossly at just pushing up. So grossly just means we're looking at the whole of the extensors. So you've got within the wrist extensors, they sort of divide into little muscles as well. So the one which we're looking for is extensor radialis, and you're going to push up with the middle finger, and that will normally bring on that pain. If you're looking at whether a strap might be quite good to help, what we can do is we can actually move, so you kind of lift up through the muscle, move it across slightly, and then repeat the test. And if that is less painful, then we would say, right, okay, the strap's probably going to work in that position, or we would move it into a different position if it didn't. And then that's why K-tape is normally a bit better than a strap. The strap's normally really, really helpful though if you're at work and you can just offload it. Remember that the strap isn't a long-term solution. You must do your strengthening. So many people go for so long with pain and they just can't do the things that they want to do. They find it very debilitating. And actually, what's really good about tennis elbow is they normally get better if you do the right thing, but you have to be consistent. Lots of reasons people aren't consistent. They're fearful of pain. They're worried that it's not going to work in the therapist that's seen them, that the diagnosis is correct. So really, really make sure that you're seeing a professional that is experienced in tennis elbow, who can differentiate between making sure that it's not coming from your thoracic spine or your neck or a nerve coming down, and make sure that you've got the right treatment, because there's no point doing 3 months of tennis elbow exercises to find out that it's a nerve referral from your neck, as a few people have come in recently for second opinions, and it's actually being sorted in one session because all it was elevation first rib, referring with neural signs as well, and we were able to sort it quite quickly. Anyway, I hope that's been helpful for you. Please subscribe somewhere around this video. There'll be a little button that you can click, and I look forward to seeing you on the next video for some more helpful tips from the physio crew. Take care.